from the get-go, they were giving us basically no hope that it was a very bad stroke and he probably wouldn't do well. He was in ICU for 2 weeks and he couldn't talk at all. He couldn't move his arms or legs at first. And then he came home and he couldn't, like the TV channel, he couldn't do the TV channel changer at all.
Even with his good hand.
He couldn't understand what it was. He couldn't read, he couldn't talk.
Can you recite the alphabet starting with A? Do you have trouble doing that? Just start.
B, D, E, L, R, D, D, E, B, D, C, C. No.
And I'm over there too. Okay. Can you get out of the chair and just walk over here? Let's take a look at you. Okay.
17. I was about to say, baby, hurry. He's got one speed.
So, just one speed.
One speed. He thinks he's going faster, but it isn't any faster, so.
Okay. Can you count for us from 1 to 10?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Say happy birthday for us.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Tell me you love me.
I love you.
Did you hear it? Baby, you can hear the happy birthday. And you said Dr. Tobinick. It was clear.
Does Bill's face look different?
Yes. In here. His mouth is more even. Mm. Can you feel your face? You can feel your face here? He could not feel his face here at all. He had no feeling here at all. He couldn't feel his ear before, so he couldn't clean his ear with a Q-tip. Now, it is hard because he is going across his head, but he couldn't feel his ear or the side of his face. Oh, my God.
Okay, so you're going to do it?
Go ahead.
Dr. Tobinick's office, and your dad, we have this number written down, and he dialed it. You would not believe how fast he just dialed the number, and he recognized where the numbers were on the telephone pad. He can move his arm around better. He ran down the hall a while ago. I have never seen, of course, I don't know if I've ever seen him move that fast. That's actually an improvement. It's amazing. It's amazing. A deep couch that's kind of squishy like that,
yeah.
I would have had, I wish we'd have thought about it. I would have had to go over there and get him by his hand and pull him up with every bit of strength I had to get him up.
Well, let's see what it does.
I'm not kidding. I wish we would have recorded it before. That is huge. Which we used to dance a lot, and we couldn't dance because his leg, he couldn't move around. And all right, how about that?
What improvements have you seen since after the shot?
Well, see, the most major ones are he can get up and out of the chair, where he really most of the time would require a little bit of assistance, somebody pulling him up. His balance is incredible. He used to fall over doing the little things, and now his balance seems to be very good. He can dial numbers. He can feel his face. He can touch his ear. He is aware that he has this side of his head, and it exists, and he can touch it and feel. He can feel his right arm, and he's aware that his right arm is a part of him. He had a really nice watch, and he gave it to our son because he didn't think he'd ever be able to tell time again or have a need for it. Even digital was hard for him. Well, he can tell time. He can tell time now.
How long did it take for him to be able to read time after the shot? When was he able to do it?
It was the first afternoon. It was about an hour and a half after he got the shot. He could look at my watch. And I said, there's only a 3, a 6, and a 9, and the rest are dots. And for some reason, I said, well, tell me what time it is. And I have my watch, and this is a little watch. And he, I think it was 4:20 when he did that. He said, 4:20. Oh my gosh! And he can tell. And we've done this a bunch of time testing him, and he can tell every time what the time is on the watch. Today, we were in the hotel, and there was a computer there. We were going to get our boarding passes, and I thought, you know what? He couldn't type before. He couldn't find the letters. He couldn't do it before. We had a friend that spent months trying to get him to be able to use a computer to give him another means of communication. You know, some people might not get it because they've never watched him struggle through trying to type something. We finally just gave up because it was just too impossible for him. And I said, well, you know, let's just have Bill sit down here and see what he can type. I said, I just can't wait. I just got to see what he can do with the typewriter or the computer board. And thought a couple times he wasn't knowing what he was doing. We said, type your name. We just wanted something simple. And he started typing I, and then he did a space, and he finally typed in, I love my wife.
And it made us all cry.
And then he went back and typed my name. But he could do it without any leading from us. He just found the letters. There it is. He could not shave himself with a razor and razor blade at all. But since he has had the shot, he can with a razor and razor blade. But this has to do with him being able to feel his face. He is aware of where the blade is on his face, and if it's not right, he can shave him. He has shaved himself every day since he has had the shot.
Is it touching? Does it feel different? Does this feel different? What's different? You can feel more? You can feel more. Yeah. Yeah, you can tap with your left hand when I touch you. Ready? Okay. All right. Very good.
I have known Bill for probably 20 years, and his son and my husband's brother are very, very dear friends. Yes, he's known my husband since he was a little boy. And I think the most amazing thing was whenever I was doing our boarding passes this morning, and they had told me that they had tried to help him to learn to communicate with the computer, and so that he would be able to have another means of communication. And they said, let's just see what he can do with the computer. And he sat down at the computer, and we just asked him to type Bill. And he starts typing, and we're thinking, he's not even close. He's typing, I love my wife. And he's teasing with us. And he is typing. Then he types, when we tell him to type, he types his son's name. He types his daughter's name. Then we tell him to type Dana's name. And we think, he starts going B, and I'm thinking, he's typing this totally wrong. I-G-O. And he's typing bingo. And she goes, oh my God, I know what he's typing. And I didn't even know that this was his pet name for her, and this is what he called her. And she goes, I know what he's typing. And we're jumping up and down because all of a sudden we realize it's his pet name, and he is typing his pet name for her and doing it without even us. We're telling him to type Dana, and he's typing his pet name, and he's typing bingo. And she knew. And the first thing when we were saying type Bill, type, we wanted him to start with something easy. I love my wife. And it's like, he's got another means of communication now. This is something he's been working to have another means of communication. Not only is his speech better, but he's got another way he can communicate to the world now. We have it printed out and written. The first time he typed his son, his children's names, his pet wife, his pet name, and his life has just changed. I mean, his life has changed.
What?
Right now. So last night was the first time I actually was able to witness since the injection all the things since I've seen him on the FA airport. Last night was the first time I was able to witness the things that happened, and then just the things that happened right before our eyes and the things that are happening right this minute. He's having sensations and feelings coming back in his arms. And
what now?
Right now.
What
now?
Since we got home the last time, but
yes.
I wanted you to see it.
Yes.
When I told you he could literally run,
yes.
He couldn't run before. He can run.
Yeah.
So, you were moving on.